This tutorial shows you how to conduct a simple linear regression in SPSS and interpret the results. I highly recommend starting with a scatter plot to visualize the relationship between the independent and dependent variables. To do this in SPSS, go through Graphs, Chart Builder. Select the scatter plot from the gallery on the bottom left and use the simple scatter plot by either double-clicking it or dragging it to the white box above. The dependent variable should be dragged onto the y-axis, the independent variable onto the x-axis accordingly. In my example, I will try to explain income solely with IQ. Upon clicking OK, my plot is created and displayed. We can observe a positive relationship between IQ and income, meaning higher values of IQ are associated with higher values of income. By double-clicking the plot, we can make some adjustments within the chart editor. I highly recommend selecting Add Fit Line at Total. This will insert a regression line. This is the best line, meaning it has the lowest sum of squared distances for all observations. This is also described in the least squares method, which is the basis for the linear regression. Also displayed is the model fit in the form of R squared linear and, of course, the regression equation. We will refer to both again later. The main takeaway from this chart is a positive linear relationship. However, you cannot yet tell if IQ is a predictor for income in a statistical way. In order to explore this, a simple linear regression is conducted. For this, go through Analyze, Regression, Linear. A dialog box will appear which will enable us to specify the regression model. The dependent variable goes into the box with the corresponding name. In my example, it is the income variable. Next, we will put the single independent variable into the corresponding box as well. Theoretically, you can then go ahead and let SPSS calculate the model. I will do this under the assumption that all requirements for a linear regression are met. You can find a list of requirements and videos on how to check them in the description of this video. Let's now focus on the regression output. In its basic form, we have four tables. The first one simply indicates what the model consists of. It shows the dependent variable and the independent variable that has been entered into the model. The second table is the model summary table. It is common practice to look at the third table called ANOVA before the model summary, however. The ANOVA table shows the F-test. The F-test shows you whether your model is better than no model. No model means that only the average value for the dependent variable is used, which in most cases obviously is not a good model. The null hypothesis of the F-test states that your model with the independent variable is not better than no model. In my case, this would translate into the following null hypothesis. Using IQ to predict income is not better than not using IQ at all. In order to test the null hypothesis, the p-value, aka significance, is used. It is compared to a usually predetermined alpha level. 0.05 and 0.01 are often found. Use common sense though, because p-values are only functions of sample size when effects different from zero exist. In my case, p is smaller than 0.001, and the null hypothesis can clearly be rejected. This means that my model with IQ is better than no model in explaining income. Since we now know this, we can shift our focus to the model summary to get an idea of how well the model fits. We have a couple of numbers here, but the main focus should be on R squared, also known as the coefficient of determination. The R squared is the amount of variance of the dependent variable explained by the model. It normally ranges from 0 to 1. In my example, the R squared is 0.410. If you recall, this was the same value I had put out on my scatter plot. Also note, this is the squared Pearson correlation between the two variables, which can also be found in the output right next to R squared. Here it is 0.640. An R squared of 0.41 means that 41% of the variance of the income variable is explained by my model, meaning only the IQ variable. If your R squared is lower, there is no need to panic. This is a constructed and not a real-world example. The R square measure is used to compare your model with other models in regard to fit. Obviously, the higher the R squared, the better your model can explain the variance of your dependent variable. It goes without saying that a simple linear regression model using only one variable tends to explain less variance of the dependent variable when compared with models consisting of multiple independent variables. For instance, you can add gender, working hours, industry, academic background, and so forth as independent variables and will gain more insight into income explanation. Enough with model fit. Let's focus on the fourth and final table called coefficients. At first, you will ignore the line that says constant. Simply focus on the line with your independent variable, in my case, IQ. Check your significance first. It is shown in the last column, and for my example, IQ has a p-value smaller 0.001. In a simple linear regression, this p-value will always be exactly equal to the p-value of the f-test. Please note that the p-value shown here is always for two-sided hypothesis testing. If you have a one-sided, aka directional hypothesis, which has to be declared before doing the actual testing, you can divide the p-value by 2, if the direction of the coefficient is correct, of course. The null hypothesis for coefficients is always that there is no effect or influence of the independent variable on the dependent variable. If your p-value is small enough, this null hypothesis can be rejected, hinting that there is little chance of a random influence. In other words, the p-value associated with a B's t-statistic, here 5.833, is the probability of getting a t at least as big as the one we have if the population value of B was 0, i.e. if there was no relationship between that predictor and the outcome. T is used to calculate p. The larger the t value, the smaller the p value. Usually, a t value of 3 yields a p value below 0.05. Next, we will look at the unstandardized b, which is positive in my example. This hints that an increase in this variable leads to an increase in the dependent variable. For my example, this means increasing the IQ leads to an increase in income. This was obvious from the scatter plot above and can also be regarded as logical. More precisely, a 1-unit increase in the independent variable leads to an increase in the dependent variable by the unstandardized coefficient. For my example, an increase in IQ by 1 unit increases the income by 37.37 units. By the way, if you divide the unstandardized B by the standard error, you will get the T value, which, as I have already mentioned, is used to calculate the p-value. A quick note on the standard error. It measures the accuracy of the regression coefficients, representing the average distance that the observed values fall from the regression line. Finally, a quick word regarding the constant. The constant is the value of the dependent variable if the IQ is 0. Significance for the constant can always be ignored, by the way. Using the equation we got from the scatter plot, we can see this even better. In my example, it is -1406 plus 37.37 times x. If we put 0 as x, x being the IQ, we will have -1406 as the y, aka income in my example. This is, of course, only a mathematical or theoretical way of looking at the model results, since an IQ of 0 is not possible. When it comes to prediction, you can use any IQ value you can think of and put it into the equation to estimate the income. Please note that the regression equation is derived from your sample data only, and prediction based on it should be treated with caution. Finally, it is advised to report your results, which is shown in the following video.